in the qualifiers. And we're going to see the Euro, but not on the player that's been playing. It's going to be Han switching it up from the Jet.
Okay. Well, this is such a major departure that I was not anticipating at all.
That's crazy. Especially-
it's a beautiful day, my friends. The sun is shining, the birds are chirping, and Yoru is getting picked in professional Valorant. Not only is he getting picked, but he actually top fragged and was team MVP against Vision Strikers, Korea's number one team and arguably the best team in the world. Watching the VOD of this series between World Game Star and Vision Strikers made me extremely excited for Yoru's future in the meta, despite the vast majority of pro teams considering him a complete meme. Here's how World Game Stars use Yoru to beat Vision Strikers on Ascent. So real quick, I just want to kind of talk about how World Game Star used the Yoru on defense. They pretty much used it the same way every single round. They would put the gate crash in one area of the map, have the Yoru play in a different area of the map, and then use the gate crash to reposition instantaneously so you can kind of be in two places at once. And they're going to combo the Yoru with an Omen Smoke. This is definitely a very, very good flash to use through smokes. So he flashes through, they swing, they take a fight, they get a couple of picks, and then Yoru is going to reposition himself. What this does is it just gives false information. Regardless of whether they got those picks early or not, they saw the Yoru mid, he's close, and now he has used his teleport, and they have literally no idea where he is. And now let's go ahead and talk about the attack, because that's where the more interesting stuff comes into play. Okay, so here we are on attack, and WGS has the Yoru sort of playing solo. And you're going to see him over here in the A site, and we're also seeing a guiding light coming out from stacks in the sky. Vision Strikers really likes to use these sky flashes to gather information. That's exactly what's going to happen here, is the guiding light is going to come over. It's going to flash the Yoru. It's going to confirm that there is somebody in A main. And so now Vision Strikers knows that there is a player that they need to worry about here. The only problem is that now we're going to see Yoru basically just kind of pushing forward. He is going to drop some footsteps. But what's going to happen is the rest of WGS is not intending to go A at all. And so you can see that we have WGS putting a lot of pressure over towards the B site, right? At the same time, because there were footsteps towards the A site, because this Yoru has made noise and made his presence known, we also have two Vision Strikers players who are still holding in heaven, and then this Omen is kind of floating in the catwalk slash tree area and trying to, you know, get some more information about what's going on. So even though WGS makes a pretty aggressive play, we're going to see them push forward, we're actually going to see Glow take contact and get some information there. And I also want to quickly talk about this use of the gate crash. So as Yoru falls back out of A, and World Game Star gets ready to push up middle and potentially hit B or split whichever direction they want to go, the gate crash has been thrown out onto the A site. And this is kind of an interesting use of it. It's not used for teleportation. It's actually just used to get information. So we're going to see that RB, the raised player for Vision Strikers, destroys the gate crash. There we go. And this confirms that, hey, guess what? There's at least still one person on A. We can still see that the Raze is holding A because they don't really know if somebody is still in A main, if the Yoru has pushed forward or if there's more players there. They didn't really confirm what is going on. They just know that there was somebody there at some point, and that information is no longer really valid. As WGS pushes forward and pushes deeper into mid, you're still going to see that there are two players on the A site. Now WGS can potentially push into B with a numbers advantage because all they had to do is dedicate one Yoru to hold two, potentially even three players on the A site, which frees up so much space for them to take middle and push onto B. And now they have this Yoru sort of controlling the flank as well. He's gonna find the final kill on RB there. It also is going to condition Vision Strikers, all right, even this late in the round, we need to worry about where this Yoru is. So here's another round, again, that the Yoru is split off from his team, playing the sort of lurk role, giving the false information with these two footsteps. And he has two footsteps stacked up there, which is going to imitate a couple people pushing forward. And so we're going to see that right off the bat. The round starts. He is going to trigger the footsteps, and you can see immediately that there's utility coming to counter what could be a push. The guiding light coming through to blind, the smoke coming out to try and cut off information or slow down the push. And once again, we're going to see that this sort of conditioning of, hey, are there players coming up A? We're not really sure, is holding two players from Vision Strikers in A while the pressure is coming B. And this is going to be a continual theme throughout the course of the game. And right here, I love this because it's pretty clear that World GameStar is going to hit B, or they're trying to hit B. And you can just see that the Vision Strikers players are, they want to rotate, but they can't because they're just not sure. They're not sure whether there are players A or not. All they saw was the footsteps. They don't know if there's more. They don't know if there's less. And then we're going to see the Yoru pushing forward with a flash. Again, just holding two players with a single player on this A site. And he's going to make them expend more utility. He's going to make them expend more time while his teammates are able to, again, take a 4-against-3 fight on the other side of the map. And now as the hit comes in on the B site, I really, really love this from WGS. So they have this Yoru again, still just super far split from his team, but he's going to throw a gate crash into B main. So we're going to see him throw this gate crash, and then he's going to take up this super, super deep flank position because he knows that there were players on A that are going to have to push out of A to kind of clear the angles, get information, and rotate towards B. And this gate crash is going to allow him to reinforce their post plant on B, but at the same time also hold two different angles that flanks could come from. So this is just such big value because it's almost like he is in 2-3 places at the same time. He's doing multiple jobs for his team without really having to risk too much. Because even if they do, if Vision Strikers were to push out through this way or come through this way and he has to take these fights, he can always just duck back into cover and then gate crash to his teammates so that they continue to have this numbers advantage to hold the site with. All right, so this is where things get really spicy on attack. So this Yoru has basically just been playing A by himself every single round. He's been using footsteps or just pushing aggressively with his body, taking A main control. And most of the time, it's just been him. So Vision Strikers is like, okay, it's probably just this Yoru. He's always over here. The rest of the team is always kind of trying to split B mid. And this round, World GameStar is 5-stacking A. We're going to see a very similar play. Stax is going to throw out the guiding light. It's going to flash and confirm that there are players there. And RB is going to peek out to try and punish the flash players. However, he's going to lose this duel. But not only that, he still only sees the Yoru. So even though he loses this duel, even though it's now a 4v5 in the round for Vision Strikers, they're still not comfortable rotating to reinforce the A site because they only have information that there's a Yoru, and this Yoru has been there every single round. So this looks like a normal default from World GameStar, but it's actually a fast A hit. And we're going to see Stax get completely run over here. And there's just nothing he can really do because it's 1-against-5. It's going to be a super easy take for World GameStar. They just overwhelm the site. And you can see that the rotations from Vision Strikers are super late because they were concerned that there were still players B, even though nobody was actually there. 5-6 rounds in a row, they've heard footsteps, they've heard a solo Yoru pushing up A and, you know, taking up the cubby control, taking up the orb control, but surprise, it's actually Yoru and friends pushing into your face, running you over. Full disclosure, Vision Strikers did end up winning the series 2-1, but WGS made it extremely close with their wild and innovative agent composition. There weren't any crazy flash lineups or wild gate crash plays. For the most part, they just used the tether to enable escape after an aggressive push or for a quick site-to-site rotation. It's this fact, actually, that makes me really excited for his prospects going forward. The majority of his impact in these games came from the ability to throw off the information gathering of the other team. Really good Valorant players rely on information to make decisions, and whether it's fake footsteps throwing off the initial read, or Yoru showing on one site and then instantly being on another, can make it really hard to get a good sense of what is happening on the map. For a team like Vision Strikers, who really likes to spend the early round gathering information before making a push, Yoru's ability to give false information, especially when combined with Astra's ability to do the same, took a lot of power out of this methodical style of play. After watching the games, I firmly believe that Yoru is actually much better in higher level games than your average ranked game matchmaking, because the better the players are, the more they will have to actually process and worry about the potential bad information from footsteps and gatecrash. So anyway, that is it for this video. If you liked it, please go ahead and let me know in the comments below. And I am going to be doing a giveaway of some Valorant points when I hit 5,000 subscribers. So if you would like more content like this, hit that subscribe button, and we'll see you in another video very soon.